Well, Bethlehem Church, first of all, let me say thanks for your prayers, for your condolences, your thoughts, your offers to help. Hundreds and hundreds and thousands of people have reached out. It's just been a blessing for myself, my wife and kids, my brother, his family, my stepmom Joyce. Our family just says thank you, thank you, thank you. Let me start there. I honestly believe this, and I do, that I have the blessing to pastor the greatest church there is. And it's because the people who call Bethlehem Church, the people who call it home, they're the most generous, the most kind-hearted, Christ-centered, gospel-loving people on the planet. And I try to lead from a level of authenticity and realness. And you guys have known, for this past season, my family and I, we've personally walked through a very long and difficult road. Both my biological parents suffered from long-term illnesses. But the good news for us, and we celebrate even this weekend, is death doesn't and sickness does not define their story. Jesus does. Jesus does. My dad's home, and we celebrate, knowing that his suffering is no more. He's with Jesus. He's with saints that have gone before, and he's in a lot better place. And so although we grieve and we mourn, we don't do that as people who have no hope. And we've been on a long journey, and God's been faithful and kind to us. The presence of his Holy Spirit has brought us great comfort and sustained us. And you guys' prayers have been a constant comfort. And I say this, Bethlehem Church is not my church. Bethlehem Church is my home. I'm one of you. And if God sees fit, I hope this is the only church I pastor for as long as God has me on this planet. And just this last week, you guys, your outpouring has even sealed that even more in my heart. You guys are stuck with me. And so I just want you to know how honored I am to do that. But before I move on, before we wrap up this series, let me share a little, couple of things, a little update over the next few weeks, if I can. If you've been at Bethlehem Church for any time, you know that normally in June, I take a little bit of vacation time and a study break to prepare for the late summer and the fall run of ministry and the preaching calendar. And so that was actually about to happen. In fact, today was supposed to be the last day I would preach. I would wrap this series up and then we would move into a new series. But, you know, God's sovereignty and the way things work out, the timing of this actually for my family is good. It's going to give us a chance to reflect, to relax, to try to just build back some things emotionally that have been depleted over time. And so I will be on the next 3 to 4 weeks, a break that was planned already with vacation and then also a study break. But in the midst of all this, God worked it out, the timing. You never like loss, but the timing of this has been really kind of God to give us some time to reflect and renew. And so Pastor Matt Pilon will start a series next week I'm excited about. He and I have been talking about it since early spring, called Replenish, just on soul health. A summer study, a great June study, as many of us are in the season. If you have kids of break and rest and relaxation and vacation, maybe that's what you call it when you have kids at home during the summer. But we're going to do a series called Replenish. He's going to teach it. And let me say this about Matt. He's been one of the biggest blessings over the last year in my life. Matt, when our executive pastor position came open, there was one man and one name only that I had in my mind. And it was him, and we love he and Lindsay. You guys have come to know him, and he's a great chief of staff leading our team. Fantastic pastor, incredibly great and gifted communicator. But above all that, he's a better friend, and he's trusted. And so I know the next few weeks you'll be blessed as he leads us through a series called Replenish, kicking off next week.